It is the world that has been pulled over your eyes to blind you from the truth.
What truth?
It's just mental health, you know. We have a huge problem.
It's lack of education. It's lack of education, and then it's also being committed to these ideas to the point where they're a part of you. It's idea identity politics. This is what it is. When you believe in an idea so much that you don't, and I've been guilty of this, and I think everybody has at one point in your life, you've been guilty of not really looking at it for what it is, but instead looking at it for what you want it to be and for what you've already committed yourself to believing in. That's a big part of the problem. A big part of the problem with people is you commit yourself to believing in something. And then when you commit yourself to believing in something, anything that's contrary to that belief gets fought viciously. You shut it down, you interrupt by all means necessary, you mock it, you deride it, you don't examine it objectively. You don't look at it objectively. You just look for a way to shoot it down, look for a way to shit on it, look for a way, if in any, fall back on the government lies all the time. I never believe them. Fall back on all these different positions. But at the end of the day, if you look at it from just like, well, okay, what's the most likely thing? The most likely thing is it's round. They've figured it out. They know it's round. You can see it from space. They've taken pictures of it. People have absolutely flying in the space station. There's videos of the thing landing out of the sky, people pulling people out of the water. They've gone into space, okay? They've taken pictures. This is all real. There's satellites, they're real. If you get satellite radio, it's real. Okay? It's really from a satellite. When you get DirecTV, it's real. It's in space. It's orbiting the fucking Earth. There's flight patterns that are carefully calculated that are going around the Earth. Everybody would have to be lying. Do you understand how crazy it is? I'm with you on a lot of conspiracies. I'm with you on Operation Northwoods. I'm with you on the Gulf of Tonkin. Shit, you get me high enough, I'll go Area 51 on you. I'll go Bob Lazar. I'll go deep on some who the fuck knows wacky shit. Till you get to the Earth being flat, and that's when I go, you're just chasing your tail.
Hey, I'm here to call out Joe Rogan for talking crap about me and talking crap about my mama. He's been doing it for too long. Me and my mama will tell you right now this Earth is flat. It ain't moving around at no 600-something thousand miles an hour, spinning 1,000 miles an hour, and floating through the universe constantly, okay? This Earth is flat, it's fixed, and the stars and stuff rotate around us. The sun rotates around us, okay? And I can prove that. I would love to debate you, Joe Rogan, because I'm tired of you making fun of flat earthers. And if you're so confident, come on and debate me, buddy, because I'm tired of this crap you're posting. You want to post a video today about a mathematician that says the universe is local, but it ain't real. What does that even mean? That's a bunch of mumbo-jumbo crap, brother. And the guy is holding a trident in the picture. And y'all think I'm crazy for thinking that this is a religious thing. He's holding a trident, a symbol of the devil. They're trying to feed you these lies to make you think that science is right and that God didn't create this universe, the Big Bang did. Okay, I used to be an atheist because I used to believe that this universe was created by the Big Bang. I used to believe all that crap from Neil deGrasse Tyson. Okay, and I'm just so sick and tired of hearing your crap, Joe, about flat earth, flat earthers being stupid. Boy, I'll smoke you in a debate. I will smoke you, and there ain't nothing you can do beat me in a debate, brother, because you ain't got no proof. Gravity ain't real. It's density. This paper, when it drops, it's because it's more dense than the air around it, not because of some magical thing called gravity. There is no proof of gravity, brother. There's only proof of density. That's why hot air balloons float, because of hot air being less dense, okay? Not because a hot air balloon is an anti-gravitational device. And I will debate you right to your face, and I'm tired of this crap that you're posting. I'm tired of you making fun of flat earthers, because you got one right here that will bring it to you. And I know you won't accept this challenge. Actually, no, I don't know. But I bet you won't. I bet you'll sissy out. And that crap you're posting, it's leading people away from the Holy Spirit. This universe wasn't created from no Big Bang. I don't care what Neil deGrasse Tyson says. And we didn't land on the moon. And Neil deGrasse Tyson knows we didn't land on the moon. He's lying about it too. Okay? All these people are lying, brother. And all you're doing is leading people away from the Spirit. When you understand that God created this universe, then you'll understand that there's no need for all this Big Bang and this and that, and it's all a bunch of crap. That's why the stars, the Little Dipper and the Big Dipper, are in the same position they've always been in, because the universe ain't constantly expanding.
When you are serving God, you're not a part of no secret society.
No.
No secret order.
No, no. That's right.
No Masons.
That's right.
No Elks.
Mm-hmm.
No Illuminati.
Go ahead, brother. Go ahead.
Oh, yes.
Go ahead. Go ahead, brother.
We don't bow to owls.
Go ahead, man.
Elephants.
Amen.
And imagery.
Yeah.
We bow to God.
That's right. One true God. Go ahead, man.
How can you be a member of the Illuminati and then gonna say, thank God, you's a liar?
Amen.
The Illuminati is a cult.
Amen.
All that are in it are satanic.
Go ahead.
You are cult followers.
Go ahead, man.
I don't care if you are millionaires, if you are pop artists, there is no God but one.
Amen. Go ahead, brother.
Just one.
Amen.
You can't be a preacher and be in the Illuminati. Yeah. You can't be a preacher and be a Mason.
In my line of work, you got to keep repeating things over and over and over again for the truth to sink in, to kind of catapult the propaganda.